नेक्स्ट चैप्टर मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट ऑफ करंट. द फर्स्ट एक्सपेरिमेंट इज हियर ओरेस्टेड एक्सपेरिमेंट ओरेस्टेड एक्सपेरिमेंट. एक्चुअली इट वॉज ओरेस्टेड हु फर्स्ट ऑब्जर्व दैट अ मैग्नेटिक मटीरियल केप्ट नियर अ करंट कैरिंग कंडक्टर gets attracted towards the conductor. So it was first visible and observed by Oersted experimentally. It is a simple experiment. In his experimental arrangement, he has a conductor AB connected with a battery and key. So when you plug in key, current begins to flow through a conductor, right? And there is another circuit I have shown here, in which the polarity of the battery is reversed. What kind of arrangement? This wire AB is vertically like this. Down to it here, a compass needle is kept, because there is only magnetic needle and compass needle which can easily detect the presence of magnetic field in any region. Correct? So observation number one, when current is passed through a conductor AB from A to B, it is observed that compass needle deflects. Suppose this is a north pole, black one, and this side is a south pole of the magnetic needle. So when current will pass through a conductor AB which is right over it, कंपस नीडल डिफ्लेक्ट हो जाती है. नॉर्थ मूव्स दिस साइड, साउथ मूव्स दिस साइड. हाउएवर इट्स इक्विलिब्रियम पोजीशन वाज दिस. नाउ नॉर्थ इज शिफ्टेड दिस साइड, साउथ हैज शिफ्टेड दिस साइड. सो डिफ्लेक्शन इन कंपस नीडल इटसेल्फ एक्सपेरिमेंटली मींस दैट देयर इज अ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड अराउंड दिस कंपस नीडल एंड इट इज वेरी वेल नोटिस्ड बाय इट. So he surprised, what is this deflection in compass needle is because of the passage of current through a conductor. Second step mein usne direction of current change kar diya. How can you change the direction of current through a conductor? By reversing the polarity in the circuit. To jab current ki direction B to A ho gayi, ab ye deflection pehle aise hua tha, north pole shift towards anti-clockwise. Now it moves right clockwise, right? So the deflection in the compass needle is also reversed. Third thing, then he checked again, he increased the strength of current in a conductor AB. Once the strength of current in the conductor is increased, deflection in compass needle observed is more. That's how he ensured that the deflection is occurring in compass needle only because of the current flowing through it. That's how he has concluded that every current carrying conductor produces magnetic field around it, right? That's why this effect is termed as magnetic effect of current. It is another nature of a current carrying conductor. The moment conductor carrying current is placed, it produces magnetic field around it. Right? Second effect, one more effect you have earlier seen in current electricity. That was heating effect of current. So for you it is second effect. Now how do I find the direction of magnetic field, because magnetic field is a vector quantity, right? For this you can use your right hand thumb rule. So take your right hand, keep your right hand in your hand, stretch your right hand finger and thumb at right angles to each other. Visible? Suppose this is the conductor which is carrying current vertically upward, like this. So keep thumb in the direction of current flowing through a conductor. Start curling your fingers. The direction in which fingers are curled is the direction of magnetic field around conductor. You can see better way like this. Current is flowing from this direction towards the black cap. Keep thumb of the right hand parallel to the direction of current in a conductor. Start curling your fingers around the conductor. The direction in which fingers are curled is the direction of magnetic field. So the magnetic field lines in a current carrying conductor goes round it. Right? Around conductor. So what is the direction of magnetic field at any point? If I choose this point, direction of magnetic field is this. Conductor is how? This. So direction of magnetic field is perpendicular to the electric field. How do I conclude? Because current flows in the direction of electric field conventionally. Because electric field exerts force on a charge, positive charge in its direction, and current is always taken the direction of motion of positive charge in a conductor by convention. So another conclusion we can draw here, that electric field and magnetic field are at right angle. But electric field is inside the conductor, magnetic field is outside the conductor. But they are at right angles to each other. So what is magnetic effect of current? Whenever current is passed through a conductor, it produces a magnetic field around it. The phenomenon of generation of magnetic field around a current carrying conductor is termed as magnetic effect of current. Another article, force on a moving charge in uniform magnetic field. So consider there is a magnetic field, uniform magnetic field. Of strength B, and charge Q is entered in this magnetic field with velocity V at an angle theta with the direction of magnetic field. What did I consider? A charge Q enters in uniform magnetic field of strength B with velocity V at an angle theta. Then magnitude of force F is directly proportional to the charge, directly proportional to V and directly proportional to V sine theta. So when you combine result, that comes out K Q V B sin theta, that is K is equal to Q V, sorry, F is equal to Q V sin theta, where proportionality constant value K equals to 1. Since force is a vector quantity, so you can write in vector form also. Force vector is Q V cross B. Now we look at this expression. We have obtained force with the cross product of velocity vector and magnetic field vector B. Since magnetic field vector and velocity vector are lying in the same plane, then force will always be at right angle. Force will always be at right angle to the plane formed by velocity and magnetic field vector. Right? I mean to say velocity and vector is lying this, magnetic field is here, then force either will be perpendicular to the plane of whiteboard or outward or perpendicular to the plane of whiteboard inwardly, because it is justifying cross product, and in cross product the resultant vector is always at right angle to the rest of the two vectors which are lying in the same plane. Direction of force you can find in the same manner as you calculated in case of cross product, no problem. But I will give you another method that is very important law too. Let's see case number one first. When theta is equal to 0 or 180 degree, sine 0 or sine 180, both are having value 0, so force is equal to 0. What is concluded? A moving charge will not experience force if it is moving in uniform magnetic field, either the direction parallel to the magnetic field or in the direction opposite to the magnetic field. So both parallel vector VNV and negative vector VNV, magnitude of the force will be 0, no force. Case 2. When theta is equal to 90 degree, sine 90 is 1. So the force experienced, F will be maximum, that is QVB. Case 3. Definition of magnetic field. You can define magnetic field right from here. So if theta is equal to 90 degree, V is equal to 1 meter per second, Q is equal to 1 coulomb, then B equals to F. Now nothing is left. Numerically you have to form a sentence and then you can easily write the definition of magnetic field. Start forming. The magnetic field strength at a point is numerically equal to the magnitude of force experienced by unit charge moving with unit velocity at right angle to the magnetic field. I repeat, the magnitude of the magnetic field at a point is numerically equal to the force experienced by a unit charge moving with unit velocity at right angle to the magnetic field. All conditions are included. Now, SI unit of magnetic field is Tesla. It is also on the name of the scientist. While in CGS system, unit of magnetic field is Gauss. Relation between Tesla and Gauss. One Tesla is equal to 10 raised to the power 4 Gauss. Right? If you want to define 1 Tesla, then you can put more condition. Put F also equals to 0. Case 4. Definition of 1 Tesla. So, if theta is equal to 90 degree, V is equal to 1 meter per second, Q is equal to 1 coulomb, and F is equal to 1 Newton, therefore B is equal to 1 Tesla. So what you have to do it again? Nothing, form a sentence. How to form sentence? See, the magnetic field strength at a point is said to be 1 Tesla when 1 coulomb of charge moving with unit velocity at right angle to the magnetic field experiences a force of 1 Newton. I repeat, the magnetic field strength at a point is said to be 1 Tesla when 1 coulomb of charge moving with unit velocity at right angle to the magnetic field experiences a force of 1 Newton. Right? Another thing which you have to find the direction of force. To find direction of force, use Fleming's left hand rule. Using Fleming's left hand rule doesn't mean you can't use your rule. Use your left hand. Visible? Keep your thumb, index finger and center finger, middle finger at right angles to each other. And you can read it as father, mother, child. Father F stands for force. Mother M stands for magnetic field. C stands for direction of motion of positive charge. So keep this direction of motion of positive charge. Keep this finger in the direction of magnetic field, middle finger in the direction of velocity, then thumb will automatically go in the direction of force experienced by a moving charge. So Fleming's left hand rule can be used to find the direction of force experienced by moving charge.